Please be seated.
He rescues and restores us. He descended into hell, Jesus. This moment becomes the very center of human history, our wretchedness, and in this moment, Jesus' guilt, our wretchedness. Take them away, we beg prayers, and grants it. He lays upon him, and by in this moment, Jesus is cut off from the Creator and all of creation. Utter separation from the Heavenly Father. This, oh, terrifying. This is what we deserve. Separation from God is poured into Jesus on the humanity as the Godhead turns away from Thanai. My God, forsake me. And when the room of heaven and the world is all together.
He lives a righteous life.
Like one from whom people hide their faith. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. The iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, yours is silent. So he did not open, cut off from the land of the living, for the grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death.
Judas comes and betrays Jesus with a kiss. We hide our face, a sight we refuse to look at, a picture of ourselves too awful to admit. If we stand in relationship to this Jesus, the one approaching the cross, not the one victorious and resurrected, he bowed his head and accepted our sin to be too great a risk. This is not a Jesus Christ. His death, he is separated.
Jesus predicts Peter's denial. Then Jesus told them, "This very night you will be scattered. But after I have risen, I will go ahead of you into Galilee." Peter replied, "Even if all fall away on account of you, I never will. Truly I tell you,
every sort of human separation, treachery, lying, the leopard, and the sheep will be scattered for Jesus with grief." On the Thursday evening before his death, the all odds, though they all fall away because away, truly I say to you, this very night I with you, I will not deny you, alone in his suffering.
They went to a place called 14:32-42. They went to a place called Gethsemane. "Sit here while I pray." He took and troubled, overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Watch. Going a little farther, he fell to the ground and prayed that if possible, the hour might pass from him. "Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon, watch and pray," say to him, "enough of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here come."
"My soul is sorrowful, even unto death." The garden remains. Jesus turns to the Father in prayer, and he who has always been obedient from me, whip, yes, Jesus sent me. Jesus came to bear the guilt of the whole world. To drink this cup means that Christ becomes the full history of the, should I say, death to God, in him the holy relationship.
John 1, and in the beginning was the Word, God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him the darkness, and the darkness us. We have seen his glory, the glory who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who being in very nature God, did not. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness.
The first deed Jesus did on our behalf, the very first act to us, not burning with heavenly for the life of humanity. Who can measure the depth of such love? He left the Father's glorious presence, took the form of a servant, came down and humbled himself in obedience, even earned death, for he lived a righteous and perfect life. Jesus maintained all his relations. Of all who walked the earth, Jesus, nor could anyone truly, he chose.
Sadness weeps for the worthless and said that our judgment is still without any mystery. What an amazing mystery that your grace.
Jerusalem, see your king comes to you, righteous and victorious.
Me to Golgotha, that is the suffering for our walk with us wherever we go. He bros every step of the grieving solitary. It is the hauntingly unique quality of Jesus dying. He knew what he was going through. Good to him. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. To die, and he knew his cheering supporters understood him for ourselves, for those we love. That someone would know how must it have felt for Jesus to enter Jerusalem in order to save it. How must it feel for him to count that Jesus did all of this for the forgiveness.
In our place. Holy Spirit, show us the Son of God, given broken bread and the poured out wine. In your mercy, Jesus, minister to us your strengthen us for the journey you lay before him. And all God's people say, Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night in remembrance of me, and in the same way, saying this, drink it in remembrance of me. Death until he comes. Brothers, those brought together by his grace, come now, death in our place. I invite you to come down to the aisle that's closest to you. The elders, receive it together here when you're up.
The day, how long will
this down takes?
Consider and answer me.
Is it
from him, and my adversaries will rejoice when I am shaken.
Ones, they judge me. They even laugh when I fail.
Every valley will be lit when you call by my name. Kings on earth, thundering sounds of angel song. Fear along.
Jesus too has faced. They're with us even in darkness and sorrow. He leads us to life. Jesus never rebelled against, deserved to die any death whatsoever. Death for him who didn't sin could only come by his own choosing. This is an unspeakable mercy. Fired by own life, no one in Christ shall ever descend into hell. They shall live in the presence of God eternally. Christ's redemption, suffering on our behalf. No story is more important than this, except for salvation, every story hath cold, sober, and eternal. Listen, marvel at the depth and persistence and the power of salvation in Christ. Let's rise together and sing.
Oh,